Howdy, y'all. I want to address two things coming in this video. The first one being there is no trains this week. You know, I took an Amtrak and Greyhound, just didn't have any train action. But we are going to Vincennes, I believe, from here, which is south of Terre Haute, where we're at now. And we'll be grabbing a train from there. We're going to catch up from there. So next week, for sure, will be a train video. I know I said that last week, too, so please don't hold it against me. The second thing I want to address is my intro. My intro was not done by me. It was done by Joe Spinelli. I'm going to link his YouTube below. He was nice enough to do it up. He asked me if I wanted to change anything, and I thought it was perfect the way he sent it over to me, I think about 3 weeks ago. I just want to give credit where credit's due. He was nice enough to do that all up for me. And I love the damn thing. I've watched it probably 200 times because I'm a vain kind of person. But so I'm in Terre Haute, Indiana right now, which is where I'm going to be at the end of the video this week. I just wanted to put this little PSA in there to start. All right, y'all, enjoy. Hey, y'all, Troy here. So I had Disc Grind ask me on my YouTube in a comment how I stay safe out here and do I avoid other hobos. If to answer the question about avoiding other hobos, I don't deal with a lot of other travelers while I'm out here. If I am in the same truck stop, the same area as another traveler, I'll have a conversation, and then I'll be on my way. Even if they offer me stuff, I'll give you a ride, you know, like some travelers have cars and stuff like that, or, you know, can we group up and stuff like that. Very limited. Very few and far between will ever accept that offer, if ever. You know, I need to know the person I'm with, and they need to know that person that we're dealing with, or I don't deal with them. You know, you're at their mercy once you get in their car. You're at their mercy once you get on a train with them, too. Something to think about. Once you're on a train with somebody, there's no one around. Anything can happen. So I don't ride with people that I haven't at least vetted a little bit. You know, at least talked to online multiple times. John Burns was an easy decision because I saw him bringing gear to people. I saw him, you know, sending gear to people that needed it, stuff like that. Stuff people he didn't even know. So I knew he was a good dude. And he was part of the community already, and I saw him, how he interacted with other people. Other road dogs, I'll talk to them for a month, you know, online before I meet them in person. And then when I meet them in person, I'm clocking things out, and I'm seeing how things go before I get on a train with them. Like I said, once you're on that train, you're at their mercy. So that's how I deal with that. I'm very apprehensive when I meet anyone out here that says they ride trains, because every single person, not every single person, but a lot of people be like, oh, I ride trains. Oh, I do that too. Oh, did you get the crew change? And they know some of the lingo, but when you ask them questions like, what's your favorite hop out? They'll say places they don't even have trains, you know, stuff like that. And you can figure it out real quick. So you can't trust 90% of the people that say they ride trains anyway. And then on top of that, the people that do ride trains, you don't know from a hole in the wall. You don't know what's going to happen when they get that eighth drink in them. You know, you don't know how they're going to react when things get stressful, stuff like that. You don't know how level-headed they're going to be. You don't know if they're going to get themselves in trouble with the law, with the locals, with other travelers, and get you wrapped up in that same situation. You know, and you don't know their past or their history. You got to be careful. You know, so I am real careful about who I travel with. On the same token, too, if you noticed, I was south for the summer. You know, for some of it, I was up north, and I kept bumping into other travelers, and I go, screw this. I'm straight down to New Orleans and dealt with the crazy heat. And now it's getting cold, everyone's heading south, and I'm going north, you know. That's a good way to avoid people, too. Keep from bumping into spots that are farmed out by other travelers and stuff like that. And because some of these people are really lonely, and I don't hold it against them, but they latch on to you. It's happened to me 5 different times now where I either got to point blank say, hey, I don't want to travel with anybody right now, or I just say, hey, I'm going over here and I'll see you in an hour, and then you just keep going, you know. But yeah, like I said, some of these people are just lonely. You know, they've been traveling alone for, you know, months and months, and they're just happy to see another person, and they just assume that you're on the same boat and want to travel with them too. You know, but I just want to answer those questions. When it comes to safety on a train, know who you're dealing with. Especially if you think about coming out here for the first time, make sure that you know the person, at least know they're going to be level-headed, not get you in a bad spot. Make sure they actually ride trains, because I've had people show me how to ride trains, and they have no idea what they're doing, almost get themselves hurt. You know, if I didn't know how to prevent myself from getting hurt and how to be safe, on dealing with freight trains before I came out here, then I'd be in the same boat they were. You know, I've seen people almost get cut in half. I've seen people almost, you know, just get run over, for lack of a better term. So you just got to be careful, you know. Make sure you trust the person you're with, and if you don't, get the hell away from them. All right, so Troy out. All right, today I'm making a little bit of hot chocolate. I feel like people overthink it. I'm just going to warm up some milk, throw some chocolate in it, put that in my pot, stir it. It's my pocket rocket, MSR pocket rocket stovetop. And fuel canister. I got a backup canister over here. And that's about to run out. Yeah, nothing fancy today, but I'll let you know how it comes out. Now all I'm gonna do is break up the chocolate bar. Maybe a little bit smaller than this. Might be a little bit too big. But yeah, I'm gonna break it up and toss it on in there little bit by little bit. All right, all the chocolate's in there, melting on up.
It's alive. It's alive.
So this is how you be a sneaky bastard to get your electricity, charge all your stuff. Don't tell anybody. Hey, in a circle back to Disc Grind's comment about safety out here, there's a few things I wanted to mention too. Is if I'm solo, I am in camp at night. I picked a camp, I set it up, and I'm in it before nighttime comes. If I'm alone, you know, I don't walk the streets of dangerous downtown areas or sketchy neighborhoods at nighttime. There's no reason to. You know, I'm asking for a problem. He also mentioned that I seemed like a big guy, which is true. I'm 6'2 and 240, which is great for nothing. I can't fit in a foxhole. People are like, oh, I sleep in foxholes on a grainer car, on a train, and I can't fit in there. I could squeeze in there, but I ain't sleeping in it. You know, like, yeah, I could squeeze in there when I'm passing a train yard or a busy spot or something, but I ain't in there for too long. But also, I gotta be eating protein all day long. Look at this. I'm doing it right now. So I got a little protein drink here. This is 20 grams. I gotta do two of these at least. And then I gotta have a big old breakfast and a big old dinner. And then something up for lunch. So lunch, I'm usually having fruits, veggies, and a couple of these bad Larrys. But yeah, I gotta constantly be eating protein all day long. Or I just get skinny where I shouldn't be skinny. And I get fat where I shouldn't get fat. You know, being active out here. I need about 200 grams of protein a day, or I start losing muscle. You know, I can notice everything getting heavy. If I go 4 or 5 days and don't eat right, I can feel it. And I'll notice it, you know. So being big out here sucks. Maybe it's just me and I'm a weirdo, but that looks like a threat to me, right? We hire you to retire you. I don't know, maybe it's just me. All right, I am headed out of Effingham, Illinois. Really nice people out here, really welcoming people, most places I go. But, you know, time here is up. You know, the weather has been really good to me. We got a lot of rain coming in tomorrow. So, gonna go grab a Greyhound out of here, boot over. I think we're going to Indiana. So we'll grab a Greyhound. I'm hoofing it over the Greyhound station now, so if we find a little camp spot for the night, in case it does rain tonight, to make sure that we're not doing it in the rain, do it before the rain. But yeah, it's a nice little town over here, I'm not gonna lie. So I am allergic to dogs, but I pet them anyway.
Eastern time now.
Oh yeah. EST. Final struggle. I need a knife to open my knife. This is by far the funnest part of the day. It's when you lay everything out in the sun and let it dry up. Literally like watching paint dry. So the weather says 0% chance of precipitation. but it's snowing up, and I got a giant pimple on my head. So all my people from Boston might get a kick out of the statue. It's the man from the Dream Team itself, back in 92, 93. I forget when the Olympics were, where he was on the Dream Team. But yeah, Larry Bird was born in West Baden, Indiana. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. But I'm over here in Terre Haute, and they got a statue right by the ISU here. It's windy, and it's cold. But yeah, I chose this. This is my decision I made to come out here and freeze my ass off.